I almost made it there and back without hitting anything, but I forgot about the goddamn fan. I smacked my head against it really hard. My
ouch.
Hand. My head.
And a lot more to go.
How am I gliding? I have no idea.
Yeah, I was making a comment before you came in that, like, to be quite honest, this game's not what I'd call great, but it's actually kind of decent. It would be better if it was just had more levels. That's really the main problem. It kind of plays like a less... It plays pretty much like a less good, Giannis Sisters Twisted Dreams, pretty much. But... if this game was like, I don't know, $5-$10, then they... oh, God. Damn it. If this game was $5 or $10, the amount of levels would feel probably less upsetting. But I feel that even $20, the shortness of this game isn't valid. Does that make sense?
Yeah, it makes sense. I'm conflicted between tweeting and an ask for help and a just ask me anything, because for some reason when I drink a lot I just want to talk about my really personal shit. I don't know why. I'm so sorry.
It's all right. It's because your filter gets taken down.
Dude, my filter is not even that thick, but the problem is I don't drink that often because drinking is expensive.
Yeah.
Did he say cock
goblin monster?
No, I shouldn't say it. Never mind.
No. Hold off for a second. I could have swore Bubsy just called the Wooly a cock goblin monster.
How am I gliding?
You know, no idea. He probably did, because Bubsy's been in the doghouse for long enough. And he's like, you know what? Fuck your shit, my dude.
The dude abides. Oh shit.
Waiting for the opportune moment. That was it.
Look, stop criticizing me, Bubsy. I'm criticizing myself enough as is. Don't criticize me for your own game problems. I don't know, for, like, $20, this game needs to be twice as long. For $30, this game needs to be 3 to 4 times longer.
Yeah, I mean, this is no longer the Nintendo age where short games were okay because they were hard. This is a different age.
Well, shit, it took us longer to beat Yo-Noid than this.
Possibly. All right, chat, I swear I've been reading most of what you say, so... Solar Flare, can't believe you referenced G Gundam. Goddamn New Mexico space sombrero fucking shit. Que barbaridad es este. Te voy a pegar a través del internet.
Damn it, I died because I laughed whenever you said G Gundam in Neo Mexico. Because I as soon as you said that, the freaking sombrero satellite appeared in my head. And I just lost my shit. I just couldn't keep contain myself.
Hey, tú eres un racista. No creo que eres. Disculpe, por favor. Fun fact, everyone. I don't think I ever mentioned this. Spanish was actually my first language.
You have unfinished business with the Willies?
And, yeah. Oh no, someone get responded to my tweet. Oh god. Oh no!
What? Was it Bubsy?
No, it's. Yeah.
Is it someone in your family?
No, it's a friend of mine who is going through some tough times, and every time they tweet, I just want to like reach in and give them a hug because they're like the nicest people, and they have such and I just. If you get it, so yeah, so whoever's editing this now, if you get anything coherent out of me now, consider it a miracle and just like. Angelic chorus and all that, and also my apologies.
It's okay. Let's see. Oh, shit. All these... all the lasers! I will say the bosses are the best part of this game. They got good bosses without making me feel like yanking my hair out, like the last game that I played with good bosses. I love Cuphead, but God, that game will make you want to pull your hair out.
Oh my God, when I think of Cuphead, I think of that edit summary of those bird books where it's like, the risk I took was calculated, but damn, am I bad at math. I want to play that game someday. I started watching you, and is it Miyu or Drax who you played it with?
It is Miyu.
Yeah. I started watching that. It looked cool, but on the one hand, I want to watch it. On the other hand, I don't want to have like bosses revealed because
they are kind of the main draw of the game.
Yeah, exactly. That's also unfortunate because like whenever people I like who stream or do videos come out with new games, like I want to watch this because I like this person, I want to support them, but I also don't want to have this game ruined for me. But I don't know I'm going to play it because I'm fucking broke ass piece of shit.
I understand. There's many games like that for me too. So that I avoid ever watching because I wanted to play it at some time, and then sometimes I'd never even play it. So it's like what.
Alright, so anyone in the chat who's never been into one of Pem's streams before, I promise you this is not how it normally is. I'm normally a lot more coherent than this. Just, I tried something different this time, and I don't foresee myself trying this again, because just for my own channel, that's one thing, but I don't want to give you all a bad impression of Pem's streams based on me alone, because his streams are usually better than this, I swear. Dude, I'm sorry. I'm gonna be like apologizing for the stream for at least 2 months after this. God, this boss is actually I actually dig this boss design, because it actually adds more to it than just what the bosses were like in the original Bubsy 1.
Yeah.
Which I can appreciate, but because I mean, you know, that's always a problem with bosses. Like, how do you make a boss that's difficult without being formulaic? And this boss at least tries, and I give credit where credit's due.
See, and did someone in the chat say this is like Crash Bandicoot? Because that's an insult to Crash Bandicoot, which is a game that, to my surprise, aged better than I expected. I actually went the longest time in my life never playing a Crash Bandicoot game until I think like last year, which I streamed it, and unfortunately it was lost in the stream footage was lost when my hard drive crashed, which sucked because that was actually a fun video of me playing Crash 1 and 2. But the fun part of the thing was, though, I actually really enjoyed them, to my surprise, because I was expecting age to make those games bad, and I really had a lot of fun playing them. So I will not accept this being related to Crash Bandicoot.
How am I gliding? I have no idea.
Crash Bandicoot is actually a legit good game that aged way better than I expected, so... All right, we almost there. 6 more lives.
Who said me? Your fur dresser. Air control to the maximum. Pilot license? What for? It was a good plan up until now.
God damn it. That was dumb on me. I couldn't see the woolly. Oh, there we go. Thought the boss wasn't coming out for a second. I was like, what?
Air control to the maximum.
That is a good description of this game, to be honest. Now we gotta conquer gravity, Bubsy. That's how you play this game.
No idea how I'm doing this, but I like it.
I wonder what the original creator of Bubsy thought of this game.
Why won't Twitter give me 280 characters? Fucking hell.
Cause it's Twitter.
No idea how I'm doing this, but I like it.
I'm making dumb mistakes now, and I think it's like just playing this for so long is. You ever get to one of those weird points where you, like, you play a part so much that you just start getting bad at it instead of better?
Oh, no. Miu says that you've lost me. Did I accidentally disconnect from Tumblr? Can you hear it? Twitter? Not Twitter. No. Fucking Discord. Do you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you just fine.
Okay. Guys, don't scare me like that. Don't scare me like that, please. Don't worry, me. I'm still here. Don't worry. Drax, I'm still here. Don't worry. Don't worry, guys. Someday I'll say hello and I'll, like, you both get a hug. Unless you're not down with that, in which case I won't give you a hug because I'm very much about respecting boundaries, but.
I like
you
hugs.
You guys are cool, even though I haven't. Well, Pam, I'm pretty sure that as early as I actually start talking to you, I promised you at least a drink and also a hug. So you're still getting those there. If I'm ever fortunate enough to meet you IRL, you're getting both of those things.
Yay! Oh my god!
Unless of course you're not down for that, in which case no.
I'm 100% okay with both of those.
Okay, cool.
No idea how I'm doing this.
That's one of the funny
it.
Things about the internet age, is meeting folks, like, more than double-digit hours of travel away, who I'm like, man, I so totally wish that you weren't double-digit hours of travel away, because I think that if circumstances were different, we'd totally be IRL friends.
I 100% think that is the case.
You know what the worst part about this is? That for better or worse, no matter what, I've never had an alcohol-related blackout. I always remember everything I say or do when I've been drinking, so I'm going to feel really shitty about this in the morning.
Don't worry, I do the same thing.
Alright, cool, so I'm not the only one, but...
Granted, I also have a pretty damn good, a pretty amazingly good, alcohol tolerance, in comparison to my visuals, because I have a lot of Scotch-Irish heritage, so.
I've got mostly Cuban-Spanish, so mine's pretty good, but my family's not, has like, I think, one or maybe one person who has a high, who drinks a lot in it, so it's
I
whatever.
I just had to hit the boss one more time, damn it! Alright, we're doing this. This time is the one. Boss is going down.
You have unfinished business.
It's going down to Brown.
Get in line, pal. I've been waiting to settle this score since 1993.
Since 1993?
I can't even remember. I'm hard pressed to remember anything that actually even happened in 1993.
That's when Bubsy 1 came out.
Was it?
Yeah, which doesn't make sense because he fought the Woolies in Bubsy 3D. Are they just not acknowledging that game? I mean, I can't blame them, but...
I can't believe no one's unfollowed me for my really shitty tweets.
One bully down, and a lot more to go.
In case anyone wants to receive really shitty tweets at CrunchyLex with two X's.
I actually wish I was more active on my Twitter account.
Dude, I use Twitter more than any other social media, and the only reason that mine is CrunchyLex is 2x is because CrunchyLex 1x is me from my old Twitter, and which has a picture of me from when I was younger and more attractive. I can't believe I said that.
Now, I'm just making stupid mistakes in this game now, and it's...
Dude, my entire life is a stupid mistake. what are you even gonna draw a thumbnail for this as? It's pretty much gonna be like freaking me holding a bottle of liquor, like just pushing you aside, just talking about stupid shit. That's not the thumbnail, Allie. What's
a I'll have Bubsy as the bartender saying, "I think you've had enough, sir."
Oh my goodness. Again, to everyone out in the chat, I'm so sorry, I'm not normally like this. I just thought this would be a fun idea to try for once, but I wasn't expecting it to go like this. I'm more of a beer person than I am a liquor person. Hindsight, I should have had more beer. Oh my god, this bottle is almost half empty. The bottle's closed, and it is staying closed. I'm not drinking anymore, because if I did, then I will 100% guarantee throw up. I don't want that.
No idea how I'm doing this, but I like it.
This boss fucking sucks, though. You were so close to beating it. Did you just game over and lose the progress?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
It really was just one more hit. Well, see, the problem I'm having is it's one of those cases where in a video game, when you play the same part for so long, you start just making really stupid mistakes. Like, somehow you, instead of getting better, you go through a phase of getting just worse.
Yeah. Oh, and good night, that again. You get yourself some sleep. Thanks for stopping in as long as you did. You've been here since pretty much the start. Thank you so much. And I hope you won't think too harshly on us for this uncharacteristic, for us being uncharacteristic here.
Jesus Christ! I knew that was coming and I. Fuck! Should have did the pounce.
No. Drax, for better or worse, alcohol, I don't black out from alcohol, so even if I try to use alcohol to forget something really terrible, I can't forget it, which fucking sucks.
No. At most, it just does temporary relief of emotional pain.
Yeah, pretty much. So, have yourself a good night, Thad, again. Thanks for stopping by.
See you, Thad, again.
We hope to see you again.
I think they do. They actually do a blog called Pocky Twilight. Oh God! I just realized I didn't reblog this on a mini bell. I just did it on my personal Tumblr. Oh well.
I will say I kind of wish I wish I were less of a flake with art, because you know so many more folks through actually having a regularly updating art blog than I do for just having a shittily periodically updating reblog blog and streaming infrequently. But I'm just really bad about updating recently, because not recently but regularly. I'm just, I don't know. If you were waiting for the opportune moment, that was, I believe in you, you got this, bro.
That's okay. I mean, it's not something everyone can do, and let's see. But I don't know what I was thinking. I was like, I needed to jump, and I didn't jump. And it was like, right there, all I needed to do was jump on the head. Instead, I walked straight into it. I'm just like, what the fuck am I... Ah!
Don't worry, Drax. I know. I'm don't worry. Nothing that gets said today, I'm going to hold against anybody. Don't worry.
But no, I was saying, I usually reblog streams on Mini Bell, too, and I forgot to do that, so... I guess if it's any consolation, that's less people who saw you get drunk. Air control to the maximum. Pilot license? What for? What's wrong with this picture? I didn't even touch it. I didn't even touch it! Ah! Son of a flim flam. Spam! Flam, damn, scram, blam. Can I get a stunt cat? Stram, sham, fram, cam. I don't know what I'm even going with this. No idea how I'd say I was trying to refuse from swearing, but I actually said damn, so. Fuck shit.
Well said, my friend, well said.
I don't want to know how you know they're cock gobblers, Bubsy. I know he's saying something else, but I swear he's saying cock gobbling. monsters.
Gliding down. Air control to the maximum.
Oh my gosh.
I guess his voice is better than the voice he had in, I guess his voice is better than the voice he had in 3D.
Miyu says that you guys need to finish Night in the Woods. Everyone wants it. Well, Miyu, I'm just gonna throw this out there now. This is just me talking here, not Pete Pemmy talking, obviously. That the Night in the Woods folks have said they're actually about to come out with a big patch for Night in the Woods, which adds new content. So I'd actually wait a little bit to see. It says I think they said it was gonna come out before the end of the year. So wait and see for the more stuff to come out, then you guys should totally finish it, because if they add more stuff to it, then I am 100% on board for that. Because I know some of my friends want me to finish streaming, because I did a stream with the voices and that was a lot of fun. And so if I do that, then you guys should do it too, and it'll be great. Because Night in the Woods is a lot of fun. And I didn't realize it at the time, but it was made by some guys that are from Pennsylvania, which is really close, which is like right next to where I am. So I actually appreciate that just on the geographical sense, because like, so it's very similar to some of the stuff from like northeastern Ohio. I'm from Ohio, spoiler, come at me, bro. Actually, no, well, come at me. Actually, I'm that's not a lie log. Come at me, bro. If you're a cool person, come at me, because I don't have enough local friends, and I'm in central Ohio, and I need more friends. So if you're not too far from here, come say hello, because I need more cool folks around here.
See, I didn't know more people were wanting to see that. I know you want to finish it, Miyu, and I do want to finish it. It's just, there's been a lot of games that come out, and it's been a lot of a distraction. But I definitely want to replay it so I can get back to doing my Greg voice, which people seem to like, which is hysterical, because, like, my friend Dave was like, that is, like, the most annoying voice ever. And I'm like, yeah, but everyone seems to like it. I'm Greg! How you doing? Yeah! I got cuffs on my head!
I'm gonna do some crimes!
I got cuffs on my head!
Cuffs on my head! No, I had a lot of fun with that, and I actually had fun using my stupid DeviantArt artist voice for B, because I don't know, I actually really like, I thought B was cool.
B is cool. B and Greg are like my favorite characters. One of the Woolies is stuck in the wall. I got killed because I was distracted by the Woolly stuck in the wall. I was just like, is he stuck in the wall?
They're getting smarter. They're getting smarter.
They're distracting me with game glitches. The bastards.
Solar, multiplayer of Stardew Valley sounds like a great excuse to just... I don't know. This is a great excuse to have literal waifu wars. Although I haven't played Stardew Valley, but considering how strong some of the debates I have with friends are about Harvest Moon waifus, I don't even want to know, my dude.
I don't want to play Stardew Valley because I'm scared to death it's gonna be like when I played Animal Crossing all over again. Oh, come on! It was so close!
Isabelle unapologetically made it on my list of 19 waifus so far for Crush Member, which I'm still trying to get myself to do that. I want to do it along with you, but I'm such an art flake. I'm sorry, dude.
It's all right. It's like, it wasn't even like that Animal Crossing. Like, honestly, I haven't played. I've never played New Leaf, which is the one with Isabelle in it. I just like Isabelle and Digby's design a lot. But no, I played the first American-released one, the one that was on GameCube, and I was so obsessed with it. Me and my friend Leroy got so obsessed with it, and my roommate Will, that pretty much, like, me and Leroy would be, like, hanging out with people and randomly just be like, oh shit, guys, we gotta get back home because the new KK Slider song's gonna come up. And it practically, that whole game was like running our lives. And we're just like, this is getting uncomfortable. And my roommate Will got so obsessed that he was like, yeah, I have to take a nap early in the day today because I need to be up at midnight so I can get fireflies. So It was like that game practically was ruling our lives, and it was just like, I had to stop it, and I was just like, never played another Animal Crossing game again, because I was just scared the same thing would happen. And having ultra adorable Isabelle and Digby would not help, I'm sure, so I was like, I'm not playing this ever.
All I know is that I played it, and at one point I walked into the mayor's office, she was asleep, and I'm just like, well, I walk up and she's like, and she's apologizing for just falling asleep. She's like, I'm so sorry for falling asleep, but I promise you I was dreaming about work. And I'm like, Isabelle, please, sweetie, just go on vacation. I don't even care if you go on vacation with me or not. Just go on vacation. Don't worry too much about work. Please.
It's all for what's best for the town, sir. Which has been taken into some pretty uncomfortable levels with fan art.
My town in Animal Crossing New Leaf is called Catferno, and I drew a cat face on a fire background for the flag, because of course I fucking did. I have issues with cats.
What about Bubsy? Bubsy's a cat.
Bubsy pisses me off in that regard, because a bobcat is genetically very similar to a lynx, with the black tips on the ears and other cute cat features. I'm just like, how dare you be that close to the original character who first made me realize that animal girls are... And spoiler alert, Sonic ruined me.
I didn't know you had a thing for Sonic. Sonic's your husbando?
No.
I know, you're referring to the series.
Yeah, it's pretty much like a matter of just like, it's like, a friend of mine pretty much made me decide that furries are gross, furries are terrible, and then I caught up on Sonic comics, and I was like, oh my gosh, my favorite character from the Sad AM show is actually a cute cat girl, and I guess I'm one of these people now. No one must ever know, so here I am admitting it on a stream in 2017.
Now, my whole thing with the, I say I'm not a furry, and people will constantly make the joke that I am and give me crap for it. And I've explained this a million times. My problem isn't whether or not I'm a furry. It's more I just don't like labels.
No, I understand, because the problem is, because for better or worse, even regardless of how many cool people you meet in the furry fandom, the term furry carries a certain negative connotation about it. Which is unfortunate, because I met so many cool folks through it.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's just kind of like, you're almost afraid to say, to admit that you, at least in my case, I'm almost like afraid to say it, just because a combination of just like, I don't want to have to deal with all the negative stigma attached to it, and also just because my one friend who, my closest friend who is, I get the feeling that if he found out, he would just never let me live it down. I'm just like, dude, you didn't convert me. You didn't do anything. If anything, it took me longer than I thought it would to get to this point because of you. But it's just like, I think that's the thing. It just kind of happens.
Yeah. Well, it's the fact that a lot of labels, like, just the general public, if they know of that label, they always know about the worst people in that particular group than anything else. It's the case of furries, it's the case with bronies, it's the case with, like, anime fans, gamers, you know, all of them.
Yeah, absolutely.
Bronies means you want to fuck horses. Anime fans mean you're a pedophile or just a sexual deviant in general. Gamers, you rage and want to shoot people in the head and probably, like, have very bad anger problems. You know, furries, you want to fuck, you want bestiality, which I would say there's a definite difference between wanting to have sex with an anthropomorphic character and an actual cat or dog. So.
No, yeah, that's the reason why that's the sort of thing that's like, I can't have a conversation with my family, like, ever, because it's like, oh, well, if that, then what's to stop you from, I don't know, fucking a cow? Because that's completely different.
Yeah. It's not a sentient being.
Exactly. That's what it comes down to, sentience. But that's not what we're here for. We're here to talk about why this boss is bullshit.
And Bubsy is also bullshit.
A little bit, yeah. But cats are not bullshit. Cats are love, cats are life.
But Bubsy's an exception. Cats.